Cornell Cooperative Extension of Orange County presents.
Welcome to Cat Science. Orange County 4-H, New York presents Pollo de Leche, Body Parts and the History of Cats. Today we're going to dive in and learn all about the history of cats, where they started, the discrepancies within history, and then what their body parts do to help them make one of the top predators. So the history of cats. While 12,000 years ago might seem like a bold estimate, nearly 3,000 years before the first date of the Cyprus tomb cat was discovered, agriculture societies began to flourish in the Middle East. Thoughts and discoveries have also said that the African wildcats were used to catch vermin nearly 8,000 years ago. Then the cats had been domesticated for the same purpose and can be traced all the way back to ancient Egypt nearly 4,000 years ago. Now, some of these facts are originally disputed because wild cats and domesticated cats have such similar body structures. So what do we know? After serving their purpose for protecting crops from diseases and catching vermin, cats became owned by only the rich. They were a status symbol to have. The domesticated cats made its way to the surrounding countries like India and Japan. And from there, the first breeds were recorded, such as Siamese and Burmese cats. It's been said that Egyptian traders originally introduced cats to Europe. The Greeks and the Romans used them for pest control, as we said before, like many other ancient societies. But did you know, during the Middle Ages in Europe, cats became associated with superstition? Now, during this time, the Black Death, around 1348, rulers ordered the killing of cats because they were suspected of carrying diseases. Since then, it took nearly 300 years for the domesticated cats to recover. But don't worry, they made a comeback. So coming to America, it is commonly thought that Christopher Columbus discovered America and cats from his ship escaped. This is said to be the start of the American short-haired cat. In our next video, we're going to learn all about the American short-haired cat as well as some other breeds that are recognized by cat associations. Nowadays, cats are a key part of our modern society. They are living in and outdoors for pleasure as well as purpose for our everyday life. Today, there are estimated to be close to 500 million cats around the world. And just in the United States, there are 72 million cats that are living in homes. So breaking down our cats' body parts, as you can see from nose to tail, there are different names of different parts, and all of those parts serve as a purpose to help cats make the top predator and snuggler that they are today. Now, with the anatomy of a cat, we can go for things like paws, and then we can break them down to metacarpals. We can go for things like a rump and break that down even further. And as we move through breaking down the parts of a cat and naming the parts of the cat, we discover that all of those parts lead to what cats are today. So let's check in with Riley and Frank and Pollo and see how many body parts we can name, and let's see what those body parts are used for today for Pollo in his world of snuggling at home.
Let's learn about Pollo's body parts.
All right, everybody. Can somebody point to his neck? Very good.
It's under his fur.
Can you guys point to his ears? Can you point to his tail? Can you point to his rump?
Right here.
Yes. Can you point to his hocks?
Hocks here?
Nope. Right. Very good, Riley. Right there. Can you point to his abdomen? It's his belly. Very good. Can you point to his nose?
It's a little nose.
Can you point to his elbow?
It's under my arm.
It's under your arm.
I got one.
Perfect. Nope, that's the hawk.
Uh-oh.
All right. So did you guys learn a lot about body parts for Pollo?
Yep.
And does all of Pollo's body parts help make him who he is today?
Yeah.
Because without his eyes, he wouldn't be able to see his snacks, right?
Yeah, snacks.
without his...
He would probably smell the snacks. Probably.
He could smell the snacks with his nose very good.
And maybe he would crash into
walls. He wouldn't have his... He couldn't use his paws, right?
To scratch.
Uh-huh, to scratch. So you guys having fun doing cat science?
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us. We'll catch you soon.